out here in the Mojave Desert with Limoneira Company. And believe it or not, you can actually do pretty good farming in the desert. We've been working with Limoneira Company since early this summer. We did the first application of LNC at their ranch in Yuma, Arizona. Also a desert condition location where we, after applying it for 50 trees, quickly saw very significant results in terms of the potential of water savings, which supports the things that we're trying to prove here at a larger scale now at the Cadiz operation.
This is a 640-acre farm that we started farming about 10 years ago, okay? Basically lemons, okay? And well, as you know, we have been struggling a lot here, but we keep pushing forward.
You keep pushing forward and continuously finding innovations to support both the sustainability pillars of your organization and to continue driving profitable agribusiness.
Yes, we believe in these operations and we believe in desert farming. But we know we have to think outside the box. We know that we need to overcome, you know, all the challenges that we have and face. And the only way to do it is basically through innovation, technology, and initiatives like this one with LNC. You know, these are all part of everything that we want to accomplish. So yes, we're looking for profitability and sustainability here.
What changes are you looking to achieve with this?
Some of the ideas that we have incorporated in the past 3 years is the use of compost and organic materials. But of course, you know, this is also it's not so cost effective. And not just because of the price of the material, but it's the transportation all the way over here, you know. So that adds up into the final, you know, cost per acre. And it takes a long time, you know, it takes a long time to impact desert sands. So what we're basically looking through this initiative of using LNC is to have a quicker result and definitely impact the use of, first, the amount of water that we use in the desert, because it percolates so fast, right? The other part is the fuel usage. We, in this environment here, we use diesel fuel to generate power for all of our engines to get the water out. The other thing, and the other part of it, is irrigation. We never stop irrigating during the summer here. So these are 24-hour cycles with people changing from one set to the other to the other. So there is a tremendous amount of labor included into all of this. Then the other part is the fertilization, right? We know that we're not very effective in delivering that amount of nutrients to the root systems. A lot of it will surpass. So all of these are some of the, you know, variables that we want to impact with the use of LNC for sure.
What we have invented is a process called LNC, liquid natural clay. So this is a way where we take natural minerals like clays and we process them into a liquid nearly as thin as water. The beauty of this liquid is that we can apply it directly to the surface of the land and it will percolate in by the force of gravity and then create this soil structure that retains water and nutrients just like a sponge. The ability to do this as a liquid is extraordinary, and doing that makes it very scalable in an environment like we see here. We can simply just apply it to the trees, we can apply it through irrigation systems and then achieve significant water savings and savings of fertilizers and energy consumption for pumping the water here. And that's basically what we have done at Desert Control as our innovation to contribute to making Earth green again.
This creates the base, right? This creates the base for all these other techniques that we could use to capitalize, right? In the correct form, in the correct way. Because right now, you know, there are many things and many ideas that come across the team. to include in our, you know, everyday programs. But sometimes, because of the interesting characteristics of sand, the perpetuity of your practices is maybe is very short term. So definitely, yes, this creates, or this is setting the stage for all these other benefits that can be included into a cultural practice for not only citrus, but for many other crops.
I hear very often that it's said that farmers are conservative and they don't like change and they want to repeat whatever worked for last year's harvest. But that's not what I'm seeing and hearing from everybody in your team. So how do you create this culture of innovation and challenging the status quo and continuously looking for improvement?
Yes, I think out of everything, getting the mindset of groups is very important, because you can have the best programs, you can have the best technology of the world, but if you don't have the right set of mind and your right people to execute and make that a reality, it's very difficult. But our team is a very forward-thinking team. We like to dream. This is something that drives us every single day to come to the farm and work, because we have a clear vision. And I think that's where everything starts. You have to be able to visualize where we or you want to get. And we know where we want to get. We have those parameters very well set in the team, and everybody is thriving to get them. We always look for very curious minds. So you're gonna find that in our team at Limoneira, we're very curious about things, and we pretty much try everything. And because we know that we owe it to ourselves, and we owe it to society and humanity, right? So we're very open. We're a very open team, very enthusiastic. And that's how we thrive. That's how we get here every single day, to be able to dream and accomplish.
Because innovations and projects like the one with LNC and partnering with Desert Control, is technologies and innovations, they are an important part of that.
Yes.
But without the people and the dedication and the passion to make it happen, nothing will ever happen, right?
No. Definitely not. And there are times, and you know, when you're adapting or adopting a practice in your team, there will be times when that team puts its arms down, right? This is a cycle that we all go through. But those tough times, those rough times, we take it as learning experiences, because we learn from our failures, because we learn from being down, but we know where we want to get. And you overcome that and you keep pushing forward.
That's absolutely an inspiration for many to follow. So we're here in Cadiz now, applying LNC for 2,000 mm-hmm. trees. What's next?
I want to do everything now. Well, yes, this is going to be a very exciting year. Because one of the things that I always repeat, you know, we need to measure it, right? We need to have that threshold. And so that's going to be our main focus this year, is how do we get our trees on the crop year that we can measure all these variables, and then sit down on the table, sharpen the pencil, and actually integrate that into our cost formula. Into our business model, right? And then once that's said and done, then our next step is to deploy that in all of our desert operations, which it could be soon.
Having a scientific and field-proven approach with also data-driven decision-making behind it is what we're looking at here, right? So we'll be applying soil sensors and measuring the amount of water, measuring all of the inputs. But achieving water savings could be easy, right? It's just to turn down the water, but you have to document that the tree is actually doing well and that you're getting the yield at the end of the season. So what are the key outputs that you're looking for?
So, well, one of the things, at the end of the day, the final unit for us is a lemon, because that's what we sell. So in a per box price, is we want to be competitive into the market with still a base cost program. So what comes into there? You know, what are the key elements that we are going to start seeing? Of course, as I mentioned at the beginning of our talk, elements like fuel usage, fertilizers, labor, of course, water. And then the final impact of all of these components is that cost structure on a per box base in increments of productivity and also quality of fruit. So it's we want to maximize our space in terms of how much fruit can we produce per square meter, right? So yes, definitely it's a component of all these variables that we have the technology to measure through lysimeters, through our dendrometers, through our fruit sizing devices, our soil moisture probes, our C-tree platforms from drone flights. So we have a whole array of technology that we can actually use to prove that. Yes.
With all of this proven, I think this can also be an inspiration for desert farming on a larger scale. I mean, here in the US, everybody is now talking about this drought situation and the limitations of water that comes to states like Arizona and even California, even though California has a little bit more seniority on the rights. What do you think this can mean for agriculture in the Southwest on a larger scale?
This could definitely change where we do agriculture, right? Most of the time, you know, we looked at deserts and the first inclination is, why are we going to go do farming in the deserts with all the challenges that it represents? But I think we need to overcome that and overpass that. And like I always say, you know, necessity is the mother of invention. So for many years, we've been in comfort zones producing in California or other states like Arizona. But now we need to change, because a necessity is driving us to be more creative, to overcome challenges. So yes, this could definitely mean that we will look into other areas to do farming, other areas that for many years we really haven't looked into it. I mean, you see the desert that we're around and you drive for miles and miles and miles and you don't see anything. You don't see farming. And then all of a sudden you find this oasis here of 640 acres and it, you know, you start questioning yourself, well, this is viable, you can do this. And so yes, definitely I think going forward is something that we as farmers need to look into. And with the use of everything and all the tools that we have at our reach of the hands, right? So yes, this could be mean, you know, this could mean a great future also. We'll be right back.